We live in an era of increasingly capable machines. Systems are taking on more and more tasks that in the past we thought human beings were the only solution to. And what is happening across the world is that even in white-collar work, even in the professions, much of the, or many of the tasks that professionals undertake are either being replaced by systems or are being discharged by less experienced people with the assistance of systems. I think most professions are going to change fundamentally, some more quickly than others. In my research, for example, lawyers are very slow to change, and so are the clergy, whereas we're finding architects and accountants are changing quite rapidly. Doctors do embrace technology, but more cautiously. I don't think that any profession will remain unchanged, will be unaffected by this technology, because for every profession we've looked at, you can break down the work involved and at least identify some tasks that can be replaced by or supported through more advanced systems. Whether one fears technology depends on your viewpoint. If you're a patient, a client, a student, all that we say in our book, The Future of the Professions, is good news, because this means greater access to ever richer bodies of material. The people who fear, who are threatened, who are worried are the providers, because they see the doctors, the lawyers, the accountants. They see disruption, they see alternative ways of delivering the service over which they used to be the masters. They used to have exclusive rights to deliver these services. And so the community, I think, will benefit. The providers are under threat. That said, so many doctors, lawyers and accountants that we speak to are excited by the opportunity. They want to be involved in transforming the way they deliver their services. So right across industry, we're seeing this phenomenon. When new technology comes along, the entrepreneurial, the imaginative, the creative, they benefit from the technology, and so do their clients. Those who are conservative, those who are resistant, those who are skeptical, it seems to me, will be under severe threat. In the future, a whole bundle of new opportunities and tasks and jobs are going to emerge for tomorrow's professionals. Those who are developing systems, the data scientists, the knowledge engineers, they're the people who will be developing the systems who will replace our old ways of working. I believe they're the new professionals. I think for the young person, the choice is very simple. If you're thinking through your career, you have to think whether or not you want to compete with these emerging systems or whether or not you want to build them. By competing, I mean you want to identify jobs which you think machines will never take on. They might be creative, they might involve interpersonal skills, they might involve empathy. However, the alternative is to say, actually, the most exciting thing that's happening in our society is the development of systems that are replacing our old ways of working, and that's where I'd like to spend my career. So I say to young people, you should be involved in building rather than competing with these systems. You ask whether or not older people have a different choice, but I think the choice for them, unless they're retiring tomorrow, I think the choice is the same, because the technology is advancing so rapidly, competition is so intense, that it's a decision for everyone in the workplace whether or not they compete or build.